Mr. Chastanet took issue with what he described as a lack of resources at the Director of the Public Prosecutions Office. The DPP has already proceeded on pre-retirement leave. Her retirement becomes official at the end of March. Mr. Chastanet continues to lament the number of prisoners who are yet to have their day in court.
As a result now of what has transpired, we have a situation in which the DPP's office is in shambles. It is not 2 months ago that the government knew that the DPP was going to go on retirement. Why is it that there is this vacuum of leadership in the DPP at this moment? Why, not like other instances, was the DPP's given a contract to have continued in office for the next 6 months in order for there to be a smooth transition? And why is it that the government has been silent at the fact that the judicial system has literally collapsed because of the lack of resources now in the DPP's office?
Just a few weeks ago, we spoke to persons in search of justice for their loved ones who were victims of murder, and they too complained about the snail's pace at which the justice system is moving. Mr. Chastanet has also accused the government of playing musical chairs with the Commissioner of Police position. Acting Commissioner Errol Alexander is now bowing out of the arena after more than 30 years of service. Given these developments, Chastanet says the government has done more than enough to demoralize the police force.
When you now link that to the other actions of this government as it pertains to the police force itself, where they are actually playing musical chairs with the most important position that we have, which is the Commissioner of Police. The government has done everything to undermine the authority and the confidence that anybody could have in this police force. They have divided the police force. We have cases in which there was independent investigations taking place, and policemen were moved from those cases. We're hearing the President of the Senate make allegations about those same policemen, and also about the magistrates of this country. And this is irresponsible, this is unacceptable, and this warrants much more draconian action by the United Workers Party unless this government starts to clean up its act.
Chastanet says that civil society must come out and let their voices be heard on these pertinent issues. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.